So I wanted to tell you a quick story about a time when I went on holiday on my own. It's okay. Okay, it was an interesting variety of reactions there. The whole gamut from whatever to who cares. Let me flesh out the situation. A little while ago, I broke up with my long-term partner and we'd already booked a holiday together. So I didn't want to be a jerk about it. It was my decision to end the relationship. So I paid her off her half of the holiday price and I went on the holiday for two on my own to Thailand, home of the lonely, weird male solo traveler. I won't go into too much detail about the end of the relationship. It was my decision. I was very anxious. I mean, it might surprise you to know, this may surprise you, in a relationship context, I am apparently hard work. And not the good, not like the sort of hard work, like she's built a house and it was hard work, but now she has a house. I'm more like, she's dug a hole and it was hard work. And now the person that made her dig the hole is saying, get in the hole. Now, I don't want you to feel sorry for me at all. I suppose I've always been a bit of a struggler. I've always made my life much harder than it needs to be. And there's no reason I should. In many ways, the world is falling over itself to give me an easy life. Look at me. I've got so many of the sort of social privileges. You know that phrase, check your privilege? I've checked. I've got all of them. Look at the list. White, male, middle class. I live in the developed world. I have a symmetrical face. There's so many. Stop checking. I've got the. That's why we're in two halves. You can't be certain. I get so many. I get special things. I get the benefit of the doubt. If the police burst into my flat and saw me holding a knife standing over a naked, bloody corpse, their first question would be, Jesus, did you see where he went? There's just something about me that people tend to trust. People want me to have an easy life. I've never been the target of sexism. I've never been the victim of racism. I was once homophobically abused, but I'm fairly sure it was an accident. I had a shaved head at the time and a sleeveless T-shirt, and I was walking on the side of the road, and two lads drove past in a white van and went, poof! As they went past. To this day, I honestly think if I'd stopped and gone, guys, I'm not really that gay, they'd have reversed and gone, sorry, mate, hey, and fucked off.